Hey everyone, welcome back to Unsolicited Bourbon Reviews, episode 60. And for the big 6-0, why not do Little Book, Chapter 6, The Finish. So we went ahead and did Little Book, Chapter 3 earlier on in this series, and it was great. It was a blend of Booker's, Knob Creek, all aged anywhere from 8 to 14 years. And I think it was a 2020 release, if I'm not mistaken. But, of the six that have come out that Freddie Ngo has done with the Little Book series, that was probably the most proclaimed or the fan favorite from everything that I've read up on it. And, you know, the opinion of some folks who've had all six of these. Mind you, I've only had two. But I thought 3 was great. So with this 2022 release of Chapter 6, there's a lot of buildup on it. And I think because 3 was great and then 4 and 5, I think didn't quite meet the expectation of Chapter 3. So they, there's a lot of anticipation of Chapter 6 being, really, really good and really sought after. Unfortunately, there's been a lot of critical review. But before we get into that, we'll go ahead and talk about it a little more and more of the profile on this, and then we'll taste it, we'll rate it, and then we'll give it an overall score. So this is a really cool approach. So it's kind of how they approach the maker's single barrel select. You notice that when you pick out the staves, and it's just a different finish as opposed to a different blend of whiskey. So what this profile is, it's a 4-year straight malt whiskey finished in cherry wood staves. It's a 4-year straight malt whiskey finished in applewood smoked barrels, 4-year straight malt whiskey finished in hickory smoked barrels, and a 4-year straight malt whiskey finished in with maplewood staves, and then a 4-year Kentucky straight bourbon. So, so again, these are all four or 5 years. So I think, again, that's kind of where people believe this kind of fell short, because they're expecting more of an age profile from 8 to 10 to 12 to 14 years, like what we saw in Chapter 3. But nonetheless, so this is a 117.4 proof. So again, this is a barrel proof. And this is from Freddie Ngo. And, I am definitely, a Knob Creek, a Booker's, a Little Book fan. So I think this is, potentially just for me, I have a little bit more of a bias. But enough of that. Even for being a 4-year blend, this has a really nice color to it, a really nice amber color. The bottle, it does come with a really cool case, like the other one. And again, it's just really, really unique. And again, it's really cool looking with the seal and all that other stuff. So let's go ahead and give this a smell. So it definitely does. So we're talking about the wood. So again, it just has a hickory, cherry, maple wood. So that's kind of the first thing that jumps out on the nose, is those wood finishes. So you do get a typical Beam profile taste kind of out there. And then everything else, like definitely the hickory smoke jumps out of here. So I think that's really unique in terms of, you don't really get that wood smell, when you get the initial smell. Mostly it's the caramels, the vanillas, or the ethanol. So more of the actual palate, as opposed to, again, what it's being used for. And again, oak and wood is generally used, always used, but again, you'll get that taste profile. But again, this is the thing that jumps out of there. So with the taste, so you get that 117, it's a little warm, but has baking spices, caramel, vanilla, and then at the end you have like a smoked finish, kind of like a smoked old fashioned, if you could kind of imagine that or visualize it, how that would taste. It's that smoked finish. So I definitely get that cherry wood or that hickory smoke, which is really cool, and it's really nice for that finish at the end, kind of get that smoke profile of the different wood staves that are used. I think this is a great sipper, and I think this is really fun, that I got to enjoy and share. And, you know, again, I'm glad I got my hands on this one. But, you know, I do think this is just a little bit different. You know, what we saw in chapter three, again, is more of the profile of the blends. And it really wasn't as focused on, you know, what the wood staves or the finishes were. So I think that's just, you know, they went a totally different opposite direction in terms of the approaches for chapter six. So another smell. So, you know, again, you definitely get, you know, a smoked smell. And I think it's really nice. So yeah, I thought it was great. A lot of people were critical because they say I'm not paying $100 for a 4-year blend, but I think it's just a totally different approach, and you know, it's really unique. And you know, for chapter six, I'm glad they did it. So for price, I'll rate it a 7. So I don't quite think I'd pay over $100 again for it, but I still think it's very good. Taste an 8. So I think overall this is a 7.5, and I think if you can get your hands on it for a fair price, go ahead and get after it. So thanks guys, appreciate it. We'll talk soon.